A lot of people's got the imitation. They've got a copycat. Oh, I don't need a new religion. I don't need a new teaching. I've got the real one. I've got the real thing. The real thing tonight is still thus saith the word of God. Jesus Christ, thank God. Brother, the words he spoke was true. Not one time did Jesus try to bend the truth on you. But a lot of people are bending the truth today. They're telling you this is all right and that's all right and that's all right, but thank God for the truth that says no, it ain't all right. If it don't line up with God's word, it's not the truth. Thank God. Is it real or is it fake? Hallelujah. That's the question you need to ask yourself tonight. A lot of churches going into something else. Hey, they're having a meeting place. They're having an entertainment session. They're having a feel-good service. But is there any truth in it? Is there any word in it? Is there any gospel in it? Is there any Savior in it? Thank God, is the Lord still in it? Brother, amen. That's how you can measure if it's the truth or not. If Jesus ain't there, you just got a good time going on. But give me the truth. Give me the truth. Hallelujah. You know, in a lot of these stores, you can go in and get the generic brand, but I want the real thing. Hallelujah. The devil's got a copycat for everything that Jesus Christ and God has tonight. There's a copycat. There's a cheap imitation, but praise God, I'm going to stick with the real deal, the real thing. Amen. A lot of people are getting off into these new age doctrines. These new theologians is coming out. Oh, me and with enticing words of men's wisdom, and they're leading people astray, and they're following after it. Oh, these doctrines is coming out. Oh, you better do it this way. Oh, you better do it that way. I'm going to still do it God's way. I'm still going to do it the Lord Jesus' way and this gospel way. That's the way we're going to do it. Hallelujah. I'm here to tell you there's a lot of Christian and there's a lot of people that says, I'm looking for the next good thing that makes me feel good. Brother, amen. I'm here to tell you a lot of things that people's doing today don't line up with the Word of God. Hallelujah. And you need to get away from it. You need to get somewhere where somebody's teaching, then preaching the Word of God, and you can learn something. You can apply something. Amen. It's all right to shout, it's all right to run, but if that's all you do and you don't know the Word of God, you need to get back to Calvary's cross and say, God, teach me something, show me something. I want the real thing. A lot of ministers will stand up and tell you what you want to hear. The Word of God tells you what you need to hear. Hallelujah. Oh, we're begotten. We are begotten by God's holy word. We're kept. We're sealed into the day of redemption. Thank God. I'm glad for what the word can do. It scares the devil to death when a church gets together and says, let's have a good old-fashioned Bible study. Let's learn God's holy word. Amen. You can holler, let's have cornhole. It don't bother the devil. You can holler, let's have a baseball team. That don't bother the devil. You can go out and say, hey, let's go have a swimming party. That don't worry the devil. When you get on your knees and say, God, teach me your word, that worries the devil. My God. Hey, stick with the real thing. The Word of God. Right here on this gospel TV and radio station, you got men that will stand up and still present you the Word of God. I'm thankful for the ministries that's on here, that people are standing up strong for what's right. I'm thankful for God's Word for today, where you can sit down and listen and be taught something. I'm thankful for it, praise God. Amen. And that's what we need more of today. Hey, anybody can get excited and run down the aisle, but what are you running down the aisle about? Thank God, I'm running about the real thing. I'm preaching about the real thing. Jesus Christ is still the real thing. In the last days, how did this happen, Brother James? The devil's come into people's churches. He snuck in with new ways. You take a look around at the churches now where they act and look so worldly, acting worldly, and brought the world right into their church. What's happened? These devils have come in. That's what's happened. Hey, man, oh, there's a form of godliness, but you can deny the power thereof and the salvation from such turn away. You better get a hold of the real deal. The real deal will save you, will sanctify you, will blood cover cover you. We'll write your name and record it in the Lamb's Book of Life. We'll give you a home in heaven one day after a while. You better stick with the real thing. Thank God these false doctrines, these false things, these New Age movements, it'll take you to hell. But by God, the gospel will save your soul. And a lot of people's got into these things. Hey, man, I just got to bring it the way God told me to bring it tonight. Oh, there's a lot of imitations going around. A lot of things that's coming in, sweeping in. Oh, people will call up each other and say, you ought to come to our church. It ain't even like having church at all. While we have a rock concert, we have the lights and we have the smoke, the vapors and the fog. And we get around and dance and bang our heads up and down. And we have us a big time. And then we have a lot to eat. Amen. Not never mention. We have the Lord. We have the Word of God. We have something real. We still have an altar that we get on and we seek His face. Give me something real. Give me something right. Hallelujah. Are you understanding this?